Hello guys, welcome back to another Dice Hero, the Unoriginal Story gameplay. This is episode 3 of my mini series. And we're gonna continue story mode and continue with the Traveler. The last episode, we beat the first boss and lost in the second boss fight. So, this video, I am trying to beat the second boss, obviously, or that's the plan, is to get to second boss and actually beat him. I just started with the D8. We're gonna take a bunch of elite fights here. Shiver my timber, walking through the forest, and see a massive frost giant. It's icy blue skin, blah 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 blah. We're just gonna have to fight him. First attack. Oh, he gains 2 fortified every 2 turns. Yikes. Okay. We just attack with the 2 low dice first, and then the 2 high dice? Or do we wanna block? Think we wanna block this turn. In 13 block. And let him play out his turn. 7, 7, 7. Okay, we took quite a bit of damage there. It was all necessary. We couldn't exactly negate it all. Damn. I didn't realize he had fortified. Right. And one dice is just gonna lock a dice. Whatever. We take our harsh dice, deal as much damage as we possibly can. It's too fortified again. Oh, damn. That's good. Thank you for blocking that. 7. Let's gain a bunch of block here. And then remove a fortified. 4. 4, 4, 4. Yep. Okay. So we blocked all of that damage. And now we take the 2 highest dice once again and keep pummeling him. Just gonna gain 4 block this turn, which means everything is going to go into block. Well, as much as I can, I guess. Yikes. How much damage is that? 7. Okay, so we're gonna take about 8 damage this turn. He has no fortified, so we keep attacking with the highest dice we have. Gains 2 fortified this turn. We're then going to just shield and pass up our turn. Damn. 11 damage there. Damage. Okay, so we take 2 damage this turn. Not the worst. He's 2 fortified this turn. He's gonna have 2 fortified next turn. Oh my. I think we just gained a bunch of block. I don't know. Bunch more block. Unsure. I guess attack. Based fortified. Does nothing. Yikes. I'm gonna take 12 damage this turn. Damn. Oh my god, he gains more fortified. Let's just keep attacking, I guess. I don't know. Nice. Slowly but surely knocking down damage. 15 there. Sheesh. This first fight is taking a lot of our health away. God damn. But he doesn't have fortified right now. So we just kill him. A fight took a while, but it's fine. We then grab a d4. Yep, elite, chest, elite, elite, town. Yeah, I think that's the path we want to go. So we take the elite. Okay. Maybe we just block first and then deal some damage. Just because I want to be able to block all the damage that I take. He wasn't going to attack me, so I just attacked him twice. Now he uses two dice, deals the sum plus 5 damage, so that's 12. If that's a 6, that's 12 plus 5, which is 17 damage. Yikes, because I can only gain 5 block. Which I guess is better than nothing, so let's just do that. And it was 12, so still takes 7 damage. He does that again. He has a 1, so that's going to be 7 plus 5, which is 12, so the most he can do is 12. So if we just block with 12, then we're safe, and then attack for 7. She didn't even attack us for that much, which is nice. He just hit a pair of 4s, and if he does, that's going to be 16 damage. I'm debating on just attacking, because, damn, he actually hit the pair. Wow, okay. Yikes. Now he doesn't attack, he just adds another d4 to his dice, so we just keep attacking him. 1 dice, most you can do is 6. Let's just... So attack with the highest dice, and then block with the lowest. Doesn't really matter. Once again, just keep hitting them with the highest amount or sum of dice I can. He's going to hit me hard again. That's 6, that's going to be 8, plus 5 is 13. So let's add 13 shield and hit him for 7. She did not hit me for that much. Same thing. Oh no, this one could be 12, 17. So we're going to block for as much as we can and then attack. How much was that? 14? Still took 2 damage? Damn. He needs a pair. He can get a pair of either of them. Pair of 3s is then 12 damage. So let's... I'm going to attack with the highest dice, and then shield for 9. He missed anyways. No, we just attack. This turn's a freebie, because you just gave himself a new dice, which doesn't matter. And we beat him. Nice. I'm thinking we take the elite blessing, because we don't have any blessings right now. None of these are that good. 5 endurance, 5 fatigue. No. Yes, sting will just give us bonus damage, basically. New item. It was a mimic. Really? So unlucky. Let's use those ones, and then these ones. Oh, I can't attack first turn. Wow. How many attacks does he have? Damn, okay. Let's use these for 10 block. Then use those ones for 13 attack. 4 damage. 1 damage. Okay. Once again, gain 8 block. Or do I want to? Yeah, let's gain 8 block. And then deal 11 damage. So that's 6, and the 3. So we blocked all of it. Nice. Roll a 6 and a 7. That's 13 damage I'm gonna take. Can't even block that much. Should block the 10, I guess. And deal 4. Yeah, getting 4 block and then deal 6 damage. Seven and five, attack him and he dies. Nice. Let's take a new item. 7 equals 6, double your current block. This is once. Trinket. Enemy skip to next action. Uses 2, doesn't reset. Trinket, use once, supercharge. Gain 1 use at end of turn. Remove supercharge after item is used. I don't understand. Remove supercharge after item is used. And molt, gain burn equal to uses an item at end of turn. Remove molt after item is used. Yeah, let's just reroll all that. Heavy crossbow. 0 uses. 1 use at end of turn. Okay. Doesn't reset. Up to 5 dice, add sum to accumulate 20. Deal 15 times use. Number of times an item can be used. Range damage. That doesn't even seem that good. Heavy shield is pretty good, but I don't know. 2 dice, transform, blah blah blah. Huh. Let me just take this and then sub it in for the wooden shield. You know, I need a pair to activate it. I think it's still good. Yeah, this fight is gonna suck. So maximum damage she can do is 6 to me. Let's just gain the 18 block. We might be in trouble with this fight, not gonna lie. Cause I don't deal that much damage, and if I keep having to use this shield, I only have 1 more use left on this shield. That was the last use of the shield. Yikes. Hopefully he does not get a pair, because that will hurt. And he got a pair. Oh my. This run might be over. That's a 6. Ow. You're rough. Oh my. Okay, 10 damage there. Nice damage there. He does nothing this turn. Okay, nice. We won. We're super low with only 4 health, but it's fine. I should definitely heal to 50% max health. What is left on the map? Is that... let's just do it. Yeah, because it's another elite battle. Kind of a useless elite battle, but it is what it is. We can't exactly do anything else. We're gonna use this pair. Wait, but oh, I have too many selected. Okay. Block the 6 damage. And now we just start pummeling him with attacks. Alright, let's see in this 18 block. Nice. That would have been a big hit if we didn't do that. Not even at half HP. Now he's at half HP. Good thing he missed that. So then, keep attacking, because that's all I can do. I'm out of uses on my shield. One dice, most damage you can do is 6 to me. I'm not too worried. 6. Oh. And now keep attacking. Ten damage there. My 7 there. Damn. Ah, I didn't want to take a big hit like that, but whatever. It happened. Perfect. Now, Elite Blessing. I don't like any of those. Start with 2 Fortitude. Sure. We can start with 2 Fortitude. Town. We should heal. Should really heal. Let's do that. What is the better path here? Chant to chest? Chant's blessing chest? Elite chest town? Yeah, it's probably that. New item. We have a bunch of trinket slots open. Ring of Ave. Actually, it's all your dices. I don't understand what that does. Dice bag, reroll all active dices. And bomb, one use. Sum equals 10, deal 10 times N damage to enemy, and 5 times N damage to player. Damn. I'm gonna reroll. Thorn armor. Do we have an armor slot? We do. Up to 2 dice, give sum block an N thorn. Yep, we take that. And then it auto equips. Nice. I grab a blessing. Get an additional item reward. At the start of your turn, deal 5 damage to enemy or gain an armor slot. Get an additional item reward. Let's go 2 torso. So I have another armor slot. Chest. New item. Gain reflect. We could just grab that. Or we can grab 2 dice, add the sum plus 3. Yeah, square shield is probably better than my heavy shield. Because I can use it every turn. But I'm gonna reroll it. Main hand, pair deal sometimes 2 damage. That could be good. Sum equals 10, thorn n times 2. Let's just take this. Not entirely sure what it does, so we can have a learning fight here. Activates all dices. 1 dice, gain some thorn. So can we up to 8? D8? So at 10. This might be a D10. I don't know. So they also have venomous blood, which whenever an enemy takes damage, you gain 3 poison. That's not good. That is not good. Yeah, let's just attack him. Not sure what this does. I don't want to use it yet, though. In the 12th block. And then... 10 damage. Nice. That, I guess. Okay, so it reactivates all the dice. Nice. So I get a good roll, I can just reactivate them all after I use them already. This guy's gonna get a bunch of block now. It's fine. Let's actually gain 24 block here. And then deal 8 damage and another 4 damage. Nice. Poison actually hurts. Wow. Struggle in here. Five damage, but I don't have block yet. I think we just gain six block and then deal five damage to get rid of all the thorns. And then just attack again. Poison actually hurts. Oh my god. I'm gonna lose to poison. I already know it. Oh my god, I just got given 17 poison? Yeah, this is where I die. Yeah, next turn I'm dead. I can't negate any poison. This run's just over. I just die. Alright, well, that was the first run. We're gonna restart. And this time we're gonna go with a blessing. Reroll it. Yeah, let's go with scales. We're gonna take damage, gain 3 thorn. That's fine. Top is chance, chest chance, fight. Or we can go with this path? Yeah, we're gonna do that for sure. Oh no, it's a rat. Okay, so first thing we can do is just add some block and then skip our turn basically. And now we just attack. He doesn't attack me, I don't have to shield. He's going to attack me, so I'm going to shield. Oh, he has a pair. Damn. I'm gonna take some damage here. Yikes. And now we just attack twice. He didn't attack me. And we can just attack and win this fight. Nice. Good start. Let's add a d4. Chest, I think, and let me go to town. Yeah, that's probably best. New item. Up to 2 dice. I'm gonna reroll these. Full metal helmet. Sum equals 20, gain 1 fortified. 1 dice, deal sum plus 2 damage. Yep, we're taking the iron sword. And we're instantly swapping it out. Because it's just much better. Now we go to the town. Let's get blessing. And research with an additional idol card. That's a good one. Get an armor slot. Items that don't reload. Nope, we're going to make enemies start with another idol card. Ah, it was a mimic. Damn. Okay. We can't attack on first turn, so we're just going to gain a bunch of block here. Yeah. So I attack twice, which is something I really don't like. Granted, I can go like this, gain 8 block, and then just slowly take him down with damage. So I block that attack, now I'm tanking this attack. There's an idle card, solid, so he's only going to attack once, which means he can only attack for 5 damage. And I have thorns, so I'm just going to let him attack me. And use the highest dice to attack him. Nice. Once again, let's use these dice, gain 6 block, deal 7 damage, 6 damage. Yep. And this turn we win. Nice. Let's I think adding a d4 would be good. Maybe. Yeah, let's just upgrade an item. This one. So upgrades. 1 dice plus 7. Wow, so I can deal an extra 5 damage on every single attack, or I can have an extra use. I think we get the extra damage. Lock a dice for 2 rolls, 1 use and it resets. Nice. Plate armor. No, we're just gonna take it. If we roll like a high 6 or something, then we can just use it. Bash shield. Up to 3 dice, gain some block. If you have more than n times 35 block, deal damage equal to block, remove all block. So we have an extra trinket slot and an armor slot. So we can take that. Nah, I'm gonna reroll it. Well, didn't really work out for us, so we're gonna take gambler's dice. And is this the best path? It's gotta be the best path, right? Yeah. Chest, new item. Double your current block. And we're gonna roll it again. We're gonna have Ave, activates all your dice. Dagger, 1 dice, deal sometimes 0.5 damage, gain 1 strength and 2 blind. Holy water. Let's just grab this. Let me go down right. Roll it. Let's grab the bash shield. And then I'm gonna actually compare. So this is 3 dice, add the sum block. This is up to 3 dice, gain block. Yeah, let's just swap it out. It's kind of a direct upgrade, but in like a weird way. We're gonna go middle. Castle Shrine. After a long walk in corridors that feels like a maze, you finally arrive at a room. In the middle of the room is a stone pillar with food and gold around it. At a closer inspection, you see it's a shrine made of stone with a book on top of it. Pray, or pick up Book of Necromance thing? Necromicon? Up to 5 dice, gain the sum of a random status. Yeah, no. We're gonna just take the easy one out. Let's reroll. Gain 1 strength every 3 turns. Nope. Yep, keep 20% more block. That's good. Nope. Start turn, deal 5 damage. When you take damage, gain 3 burn. We're going to gain another armor slot. You know, you haven't used the other one yet. Main hand, great sword. Up to 3 dice, deal some damage. What is this? Gain 1 use when player losing health. Oh, katana. This is 3. 1 dice, deal some plus 3 damage. So this would be better than the default iron sword, but since I upgrade the iron sword, it's not better. I'm gonna reroll. Well, now I'm just gonna grab the katana and yep, take the chicken battle oiling blood. Let's lock that one. And then we will go 4, 3. Oh yeah, it's only 1. I forgot. 1 dice. See that? This reuses? Yep. So we gain 4. Nice. End our turn. Idle. Doesn't attack. Solid. So now we go 11 damage there. 11 damage there. And 11 damage there with the bash shield to block the burn. Nice. This is such an easy fight here. We just win off of that. Add another d4, I guess. And blessing. Gain offhand slot. This is an offhand. Empty main hand slot because you uppercut. No, offhand is the shield. Yeah, let's take that, and then we put in the shield. It's our offhand. Nice. Elite battle, venomous blood, which is poisonous. Damn. Really hate this. I just rolled a 6, so I'm gonna lock that. I also rolled a 1, and I also rolled another 1. So let's do 6 damage there. 12 damage there. How much there? And then we use all of the rest. Then do that. We're gonna take a lot of poison damage here, which I just realized. So first, do that. We then block this dice. That before use the top. Oh, this one I can use there. I'm taking a lot of burn, or not burn, poison damage. It is what it is, though. We can't really negate any of that damage that we take. So, we just, I don't know. Keep doing what we're doing, I guess. Keep tanking it. That's 13. That's another 13. And easy. Nice. This upgraded sword is huge. We need healing. I really want to just heal, but a d8 would be huge. But also just an elite blessing could be huge. Let's go with the elite blessing. Gain a main hand slot. Nice. That's exactly what we want. Because now we can add the katana. And then we have a chest. So we're looking for armor here. Armor. Or an offhand. Or that. Maybe. Probably not, actually. Let's reroll. Damn, these all kind of suck. We could, however... Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Okay, so my plan now, take the katana out, put in the heavy crossbow, and since it's based off of how many uses it has, and I get a use at the end of each turn, I'm going to not use it for as long as I possibly can. And then attack with it and deal as much damage as I possibly can with it. So I'm going to lock this dice, and yep, just this, and then yep, just do that. Nine damage. Oh no, we blocked it all. We're fine. Once again, we're just gonna block this four. This, I'm gonna do that. This. And that's an 8. Okay, we just got taken by 8 damage, and of course they rolled a pair. Wow. We're gonna lock this dice. Use this dice. We did find a 1, so we'll use that. Now 4. Another 4. And the rest is all that. Yep. Wow, that's bad. Block. We haven't really taken him for that much health yet, which is awfully bad. Just gonna deal one dice worth of damage, so it's fine. We just keep attacking here. I think we keep saving this. And then throw this all into that, and then this into there. Nice. Again, now that'll use, so that'll be 50, 80. This will deal 80 damage eventually. I'll just keep doing this. 16 block. Okay, well, we have 24 block. And that was 20 damage. And another 24 damage? What? How many does this have? 6? This is 9, 18, 16, damn, okay, so I can't, I need a 6 for this to work, 90 range damage, but every turn it gains another 15 damage. Oh, I got burn on me already. Yeah, we just gotta... How much burn is that? 13. Okay. So. What we do is we save that. Then do that. That'll be good for that. This, we're gonna keep one more round. Because it should be an insta kill next turn. And... then I don't know what reward we take, because we kind of need to heal, not gonna lie. Let's just see what, yeah, it's 120. We just do that. Easy win. Nice. But we're so low. Like, I wanna, dude, what trinkets do we have? I got all dices. Okay, we heal, and we... Man, D20 is huge, but boss blessing. Poison you get converted into burn, or gain 1 endurance every odd turn, or gain 1 attack each turn, end of turn take 1 damage for each attack player have. Let's reroll them. Lose 75% max health, all damage taken is reduced to 1. What? That seems broken. All damage taken is reduced to 1. I'm taking that. Like, why would I not take that? What? Alright, so I took the orange portal, because last episode I took the blue portal. Okay. Best path. Best path scenario would be these chests. So, maybe we go, battle, town, or battle, blessing, battle? Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so, limits damage taken to a maximum of 10, that's fine. Whenever an enemy takes damage, you gain 3 poison, and don't lose block at end of turn. Yikes. Oh, we rolled a 6, perfect. 3, okay, not bad. We use the 6 here, then use the 4, and then we use a 3, I guess, and the rest becomes block. Doesn't attack me, nice. We then lock this other 6 that we just rolled, which is also huge. I think you just gain a bunch of block, and we're gonna let the heavy crossbow kind of scale up a little bit. Mostly because I want to be able to kill him in one turn. And I don't really want to gain poison. So if I did this, it limits to 10 damage, right? Which means I just don't have enough. Block. Well, actually, I think we just do it, like. I think it's kind of stupid to not attack. So I'm only going to take one damage. Yeah, like, that was a no-brainer, was it not? Upgrade dice. Let's just screw it. Just do it. Let's go. Town. Oh, we could upgrade an item. Let's upgrade an item. See if I can upgrade the... Oh, okay, so you can't upgrade the thing I already had upgraded. However, we can lock a dice for 2 rolls, lock a dice for 5 rolls. Gambler's dice plus, add 2 bonus d6s, add a bonus d6. So these are all the upgrade paths, these green dots under the cards. I don't see anything that's too crazy. I think the biggest upgrade here would be this shield. 3 dice, add some block, and 3 strength. So that's the path I'm going to go. And then this battle seems easier because we also just did that battle, so we know what to expect. Let's just do that. And then attacks. Nice. 11 damage there. 8 damage. Okay, so we got poison on us, which isn't the biggest deal. However, I do want to kill this guy as fast as I possibly can. It doesn't matter. This guy is dead. Nice. And let's upgrade a dice again. Yep. Solid. Now this fight is going to be probably a lot harder. 90 health, and they have a fortified to start. Solid. We already have our 2 extra dice. And there are 6s? Oh my. Don't mind if I do use them. Skin log. Let's lock this one. Let's then use these low dice for that. 16 damage there. Another 16 damage there. 15. And then, skin locked. Easy win. Don't have to lock any dice, just kill. Upgraded dice again. My chest. New item. One dice deal some plus use range damage. Some equals 20, gain 1 fortified. Some equals 10, strength N. Wow, okay. But I want to reroll it. Clone a dice, temporarily gain control of it, then reroll it. Nope, these are all pretty bad. I'll take it, but not what I want. Okay, this is really bad. Sandworm seems strong as heck, bro. So, players gain free uses, units gain additional attacks at the end of turn. All attack is removed. Okay, for the next attack, blah, blah, there's 50 shield, 15 that, oh my. This seems like it's going to be a hard fight. Okay. What can I do here? Do I want to shield up as much as I possibly can? Although, yeah, I need to shield. I need shield because even if I do 15 damage or whatever, I'm gonna take a bunch of damage back because of thorns. Oh no, I'm not, because there's a stupid freaking shields and all that. Ah, whatever. Doesn't matter. This next attack. Wait. Oh no, I didn't calculate that he's going to attack multiple times. Oh no. Whatever. We're fine. Just keep attacking. No. Do this. Do that. Okay. I have one. So do that. A little bit of shield. Nice, nice. I'm gonna lock this. Let's actually. Is that in 17? Nice, 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 and then this. 14 thorns, yikes, idle, yikes. Use these and do that and do that and do that and then just shield. Lock up a DS6. Then grab these, add that, then do this, and that, then do that. Nice. 5 uses, times 15, we'll be 50, 75. Okay, so we do that next. Nice. Can you stop attacking me? Alright. We don't need to do that, we can just go boom, 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 and boom, which equals 22, so I just need 20, and that'll be 75 range damage. Huh. Doesn't matter. Wait, no, die, thank you, there we go. Elite Blessing. Start with 5 strength. That could be good. Start with 5 strength or 5 endurance, 5 fatigue. I think we start with inner balance because I believe 5 endurance keeps all the better stats like strength and let's just check it actually. Pass strength and attack and fortified over to next turn. Yeah. And then this one, which is fatigue, is weakness and blind over to next turn, which isn't great, but whatever. Wow, I am really unlucky. Got another mimic. Wow. So what we can do, because why not, is just do that and then do that. Now we lock this. Oh no, that was the wrong one. Whatever. Pick the one. Let's do the lowest ones. Go there, yep. 19 damage. Another 19 damage. And you're dead. Nice. Let's. Do we want to upgrade an item? We don't have any armor slots here. Let's, this one has another path that I can upgrade to. What it is, I'm not sure. Let's upgrade an item. What is the path? Oh, so the number of dice. Strength. That's not even that good. Rusty sword. Nope. 2 dice deal some plus 3 damage. This one, cloned dice, temporarily gain control of it. Oh, okay. So this one just it doesn't reroll it. Add 2 bonus d6s. Add bonus d6, but it has multiple uses. Lucky dice for 5 rolls. Lucky dice for 2 rolls, but 2 uses per turn. I'm gonna do this one, and it's gonna be 2 bonus d6s. It's a better option, I believe. Another new item. And he skips next action. Doesn't. Let's reroll it. Holy water. Solid. Solid thing to take, especially for boss fights or where they have unrelenting protection or other things like I don't know. Let's we need one more trinket space, I think. Let's leave it for now, and we're gonna do this one. Unrelenting protection. What is unrelenting protection? Don't lose block at end of turn. Has 150 block? Oh my god. That is crazy. 150 block? Wow. Okay. We're gonna take all of the other low numbers. Throw it into this wood shield to give myself some strength here. I will then attack with the highest numbers using the iron sword. And then with the others, I'm going to use the bastard shield. So I just gain a bunch of block. So we're going to lock this one in. And then use 9s, then the next highest ones for block and strength, and then the next highest ones for more block. And now we lock that one, go with this, this, and this for more strength. run up the 15s on the attack, and we win. Nice. Let's heal for 15%. No, let's just upgrade a dice. And blessing. Plus one strength every 3 turns. Empty main hand slot. Get uppercut. Plus one strength every 3 turns. No, not good enough. Let's... Grant item gets counter-strike. At start of combat. Sure. Let's do that. Magical presence. As I trudged through the harsh terrain, I began to feel a strange presence. It was a feeling of power and wonder, something that I had never experienced before. The more I walked, the stronger the sensation became, until I finally stumbled upon a small cave. I stepped inside the cave, and as my eyes adjusted to the dim light, I saw a glowing crystal that filled me with awe and wonder. It was pulsing with a brilliant light that illuminated the entire cave. Get closer. Blue portal. As I entered the dark cave, I felt a chill run down my spine, but my curiosity pushed me forward, deeper into the unknown. That's when I saw it, a pulsing portal, emanating an otherworldly energy. I could feel the coldness radiating from the portal, and I knew it led to a frozen world beyond. As I stood there, contemplating whether to enter the portal or turn back, I couldn't help but wonder what mysteries lay beyond. The decision was mine to take, or mine to make, and I knew that whatever I chose would shape my destiny. I stood there for a while longer, pondering my next move. Should I enter the portal and brave the frozen world beyond, or turn back and explore the warmth of the cave? I'm going to turn back and explore the warmth of the cave, aka stay in this area, the warmth, not to go into the desert or the frozen abyss. Really? Another mimic? Wow, how unlucky can I be with these? Okay, we can lock that. We can roll another one. Let's grab all of the highest dice. Yep. Easy one. Alright, so we have 66s and we get extra D6s. So I think we upgrade another item here. Wow. Add a bonus D20. But then it only has one use. No, I think the D6s are good. Okay, I think I want to upgrade the Let's go the key. And lock a dice for 5 rolls per return, or do I lock multiple dice for 2 rolls? Think that one. Heal. Basically full heal or blessing. Let's just full heal. Because we get blessing here. Let's reroll it. Plus one strength every even turn, and plus one weakness every odd turn. That's not that good, so we're just gonna take that. And then chest. Reroll a player dice. Gotta reroll it. I need some armor. Yeah, here we go. Oh, it's only used once though. 7 equals 6, double your current block. Yep. We'll take that. And now, on to the boss fight. I did not expect this boss fight to be easy whatsoever. Okay, let's lock this. Let's then use these for strength. And then we just, I guess, attack with... He's got a whole bunch of fortified, so... Once again, I take the low numbers and add them up, and then just attack. So I'll also lock down, and then this one, go to strength, shit, 21, 23, and 23, how much burn is that, 15, okay, chillin', it's easy, however, that's not good, but this should completely negate everything for me. Boom, boom, boom. Just that. And then, yep, 26. And that. Then that. Yep, we only took one damage. And he just healed. Yep. Oh, it's bugged again. Huh. Explode is bugged. This guy has a lot of attacks, and I don't like that, but it is what it is, really. Like, I can't really do anything about it. Let's just, yeah. Here's one for more strength, and then just keep hitting him like that. Damn, all my strength just wore off. Damn. I hate how he keeps gaining attacks. But now all the attacks should wear off, right? Okay, next turn, I guess. So all my big boy damage from strength is now gone. So, what do I do? Once again, since the card's bugged, I cannot see any of my block or anything else that I have. Granted, I have 4 locked sixes, which is nice. Let's just do that. Yeah, that's good. Okay. This is also really good, but we're just gonna keep it until, I don't know, forever or something. I don't fucking know. We just need a lot of it. Oh my god, stop gaining attacks! Okay. Let's get some strength here. Wow, that's a lot of burn. Luckily, I only take 1 damage per time I get hit. Nice, I missed. I really hate how he has so many attacks. Like, why? Okay, so these are sixes. So that. This. This has three uses. Wow. Gain more strength. And then, once again, just try to pummel this guy with a lot of damage. There's absolutely gonna be an explode in here. There's gotta be. So, first things first, gain 12 block and some strength, then deal a bunch of damage there. Nice, it missed. I hate how they gain an attack, it's so annoying. This fight's gonna take forever. Ever just because of that. Finally, I get this once, so I got an extra couple of dice. And now we use the lower ones, gain some strength, and let's just attack. Then we'll use the last one for that. This fight is taking so long. Let's do this, and then how much damage is this? 255. Okay, so next turn we do that. This. Oh my god. Is 21 attacks. What the hell, dude? I shouldn't need this, but just in case, we'll do it. So, by doing this, that's 300 damage. Let's just do it and get it out of the way. Easy. Glass cannon. No idea what that achievement is, but we'll take it. Alright, we're only down, what, 7 health, so I'm gonna take, actually let's check our inventory, because we can get trinket slot. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, trinket slot, and boss blessing. Whenever you don't have any strength, all damage you deal doubles. That could be really strong. Gain 1 endurance every even turn. That's good, I think. I don't know if it'll maintain. Yeah, I don't know if it'll maintain my endurance, because I start with 5. I don't know if it'd maintain it, but that's fine. This one is gain 1 attack each turn, then to turn take 1 damage for each attack a player has. Nah, we can't do that. That will kill us. This one's also not good. This one is decent, but let's just see what other ones are. In 1 endurance every odd turn. Oh, you can. I could have just tried to find both, and then I would always have endurance. That could be cool. Whenever the player used an item, deal 2 damage to enemy. Poison you get is converted into burn. It doesn't really matter. Whenever that player used an item, deal 2 damage. Is an item just anything, like an attack, like anything? I'm assuming that's what it is, so I'll just deal an extra 2 damage every time. Oh, this looks like it's the final stage. Okay. Not really a lot of choice here. Wow. Whenever enemy takes damage, you gain 3 burn, adds an attack every turn, and wow. That's a lot. So we just put in all of these, and then I guess do that. Although I probably shouldn't have done that yet. That's fine, whatever. Four, five, yep. Get some block here. Boom, boom, and boom. Man, that card is bugged. I don't like that. This one, and then we do these guys for our strength. 23 damage there, 2 damage there, and another 22 damage. That's fine. We just attack and win. Nice. We're gonna heal for 15% max HP. You know, the 15% is so low, it's still just need to do it, basically. 504, okay. Whenever an enemy takes damage, you gain 3 poison. Don't lose block and a turn. If all uses on items and main hand slots at the start of combat. Wow, okay, that's really unlucky. Let's just do that, I guess. So I can't attack. Nice, okay, solid. So we go like this. Sorry, like this, take these 3 ones. Get some strength, and then we take these. We then gain 20 block there, and then we individually attack with these 9s. Bringing 15 thorns, quite a lot of thorns. However, it does not matter. We're gonna do that, and then take these ones, add some more strength. Let's then attack for 20. That'll get rid of all the thorns. Okay, it didn't. Now it'll get rid of all the thorns. And then take the last attack there. And with the rest of these, we just convert into shield, and we cannot use zone yet. That, yep, nice. 8, 8, 9. More strength. We then attack with this, attack with this one, and attack with this one. Then we use these ones to gain 45 block. And we just gotta leave that one. So the 16s are the ones with 6 base. This is the last turn that everything's gonna roll over. So, with that being said, we need to just deal as much damage as possible, I guess, right? Like, he's almost dead. Oh, nice. The bash shield actually worked out. Solid. Heal 50% HP. That'll be 12 HP, and I'm only down 8. Or grab an elite blessing. I think we grab an elite blessing. We're against 3 poison. We're gonna gain block, gain 1 strength. Yeah, we can do that. We're gonna gain block, gain 1 strength. Or, nah, let's reroll it. Start with 5 strength. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're going to start with 5 strength. And then top, bottom. Doesn't matter. It's just the next pick that'll actually matter. This trinket, though, is kind of useless until all of my strength wears off. Remove all block from player. Yeah, whatever. This is a 6. This is a 6. And then we do this, and then we have the perfect amount for attacks. Yes, it's nothing. Breaks all my shield. Oh no. And let's just add a couple more on this, and then we take the lowest 3 and some more strength, and 24. 24 damage and 21 damage. Where? We just win here. I think the best option here will be to upgrade a dice, maybe? Yeah, let's upgrade a dice to a 1166. Actually, that could be good, yeah. Upgrade to a 1 or a 6. So that guarantees either I lock it in, or I use it on the dice thingy, the gambler's thing, this, gambler's dice. Anyways, we have an open armor slot, so I'm gonna go for an armor slot, and we did not hit it. But we also have an open trinket slot. Why did I not fill that trinket slot? I'm gonna skip those, because I don't need them. And then add this one, I guess. And when our enemy takes damage, gain 1 attack. Okay, that is not good. Okay. So this is a 1. But I can't do that. So what do I do here? What is the plan? I think I take the 3 lowest dice. Do that. I then use this, and then I use this. Yeah, so I just attack. He's gonna gain a bunch of attacks here, but it should be fine. Maybe not. 8 blind? Yikes. I was also meant to use this. 6 and 8. Okay. This one. And on this one. So we go with these. More strength. We then just attack. Just attack. And just attack. And then. Oh, we need dice for the holy water? Damn. Okay. Shoot. I keep forgetting to use it. 54 damage. Oh my god. This guy is tanky as shit. He does a lot of health. Or a lot of damage. Yep, so I do that. Okay, so we add strength here. We're going to attack twice this turn, and then we're going to use the holy water. Which, okay, wasn't amazing, not gonna lie. I definitely need to heal after this fight. Okay. 149 health. We'll do 45 damage. Not really what I want. Let's grab the 3 lowest ones. Add some strength here. And then attack. I'll just do that then. We need to heal, but that's not really 15% is not a lot. Whatever. We take the 3 health, I guess. I don't know, dude. We're also gonna change out the gambler's dice, just for the simple fact that I can't activate it. So, being able to duplicate it, or maybe, yeah, we put in the duplicator, because this only has 2 uses for the entire combat, versus the clone, or sorry, the duplicator that has 1 use per turn. So I can lock in these 2, and then I can clone this one. Nice, I rolled a 6, that is solid. Let's then do this, gain some strength here. So this 14 is going to be an attack. This will also be an attack. 0 damage, but all damage taken is reduced by 90%. Remember, your enemy takes damage, you gain burn. Wow, by 90%. That is crazy. Anyways. Now I use that, and nice. Next turn should be free. Because he no longer reduces like that much. Anyways, I should just kill him, right? Yep, there we go. Easy. I should heal, but I know the next one is a heal. So, let's just add a d4. Yeah, 75% health heal. Take that. Reverse all uses on enhanced slots and transform rage for trigger on death cannot be removed. Okay. So this is my 6, so I'm going to use it twice. I'm then going to clone it. Oh, it rerolls it. Right, I forgot. Okay. Take the lowest dice. Do that. Then we take the highest dice. Because I forgot to do that. And then we go with this. Nice. Does nothing. So 14 is the sixes. Okay, I don't know what I did there. I got lost, not gonna lie. Clone of dice. Yeah, why can't I? Okay, there we go. There we go. Nice. Got it. So we attack with that. Wait, what am I doing? I need to quickly use the shield. So I gain some strength. Nice. Now we do that. We're gonna take a lot of damage here. By a lot, I mean 3 damage. Okay, so 18s. That. Wait, why didn't it gain me strength? Confused. Guess it doesn't really matter, but. Oh, blindness. I really wish I lost or took away this one so I didn't have to finish the rest of the boss fight. It would have just fucking. After this phase, he would have just died. Would have been a little funnier. Gains an attack every turn. Now he gains two attacks every single turn. Wow. Okay. This is going to suck. Bro, this is going to suck. Real bad. This is really gonna suck. Damn, really? Let's clone a dice first. Okay. So this. Wait, no. 1, 2. It's 15, 20. 165 damage there. And then. Oh, it's only 19. Wait. Where's the cumulative 23? I don't know why the cumulative was higher, but easy win, I guess. All right, easy. Anyways, that'll be it for this video. Thank you for watching. And if you have enjoyed, please give this video a like. And if you find that you come back and watch my content more and more often, please subscribe so you never miss anything. And next week I'll be back playing this game. See if I can do it faster, or maybe I'll play a new class. But yeah, anyways, have a good rest of your day, and see you later.